Okay, babes. Now, before we let you loose in LA, we're gonna test you, he says. You are, after all, the richest communication I could have with the world, from this position of peculiar isolation within it. We therefore need to equip you as best we can. So let's give you a little backstory, in the form of memories of another city, as depicted on that postcard you're holding. And rather to her surprise, there in the photo on the postcard is herself. She's leaning at a metal balcony railing above the lower tip of Manhattan, looking down on it from 2 or 3 miles height, with the calm of a winking satellite on a cool summer evening, but welling up with enormous love for the familiar form of this unique and electrically powerful little island. It's long and thin, yet hard as nails and concrete. Its lower west side and furthest lower east side bristling with piers, which tells her she's looking at its past, not at its present. The East Village spreads out sunlit beneath her left elbow. The 59th Street Bridge soars over the slim line of Roosevelt Island as if the latter is a ship gliding down the East River beneath the bridge's span. Hunt's Point is at the top of the image, dim and flat, with Rikers Island and the Brother Islands just beneath it. Her dark dress billows behind her, perhaps in a slight breeze on the balcony, in echo of the flow of her hair down the back of her white t-shirt. This being a monochrome image, she cannot tell what colours her actual dress and hair were. She flips the postcard over. Copyright David Lombard, Girl at Railing, Reproduction Prohibited, says the caption of her image, which she has to uncover by peeling off a black self-adhesive sticker she'd affixed to the card in some intervening year. Remember? Jaymi asks her, because I sure remember. I had that on my wall beside my desk throughout the time I lived in New York. Pink noise whirs through his laptop speakers.